Hi, I'm Aaron, the owner of Brisbane Yamaha, and I keep getting asked, mainly by Victorians, it must be a snapper thing out in the bay, do a YouTube on the new 5 metre Fishabout. Now, so I thought for all you Victorians down there with that dictator Dan Andrews, while you hide in the cupboard with a tinfoil hat on, you can look at a YouTube and have a look at this and imagine you're in Queensland, because that's great up here, blue skies every day. But let's have a look at this, because my parents are in Victoria. Hi, Mum and Dad, my brothers. Now, let's start. Now, what they are, we've got a special thing here. We've got the swing away drawbar on the trailer. So that's just an option we can do. It's not that much, 600, 700 bucks, but it reduces it by about 600 in long. And we've seen how that happens before. We've got a 1298 trailer on this, and look at that hull. You know, 4 mil hull, 4 mil sheets in the hull. It's got the blade hull, you know, and look at that. It just slices through, squirts it out low, rides on confused water. And that's why one in four boats is a Quintrex that's sold, because they're just better. They're just better. And if you don't think they're better, I bet you haven't been in one. Now, look at that flared bow. Just squirts it out, keeps you dry, poly-molded anchor well. Now, this boat's got a 77 litre fuel tank. Its maximum horsepower is for a 90. It'll take 5 people, so it'll take that family out. It's beautiful and painted. And what else it's got is it's got a bait board on it. Maximum horsepower is 90, and we've put the 90 Yamaha. Dan will put it up, because the 90's just, geez, we've sold a lot of those, haven't we, Dan?
Yeah.
It's unbelievable. Since the 90 came out, I don't know if anyone's bought a Suzuki. They used to buy a Suzuki because we didn't have a 90. Now, seems like every day, 3 or 4 of these little beauties are going out. We've got a big low rant sounder. Incredibly reliable. They just go. We've got the, you know, have a look at that drive on trailer underneath, because it works beautiful. The Quintrex alloy trailer that comes standard with them. Standard. You know, go and ask some of your other boat manufacturers for an aluminium. It'll cost them a fortune. Now, what we'll do is, I've got a tape measure here, and I couldn't find anyone else at the boat ramp. So I'm just going to measure myself. Right, I'll measure at the back, just quickly on the beam. And right there's 2 metres, oh, it's about 17. And then we'll come up here, because the sheet said it was 2.2. Oh, 2.2's out there, I'm struggling. 1.18, I don't know, maybe the spec sheet's out, but that's why we do the truth-o-meter, the Brisbane Yamaha truth-o-meter, just to see if anyone's telling porky pies, and I think they are. I reckon it's 2 meters 1.8 at the widest. Freeboard. So, we come to here, 600. What we thought. Now, I want to do this measurement across the back of the waterline, because a lot of people are commenting on the waterline on these Quinnies. Try and hold that, Dan. Go over there and quickly hide it. This is riveting TV, I'll tell you. Hold it there and I'll measure it. 18, well, nearly 1900. So it's a big beamy boat, right? It's a big beamy boat, and there's a lot of boat in the water. Rear lounge, fold down, take it out. You've got a couple of clips there you put in so that it doesn't fall out. Move in and take out. We've got the bait board with a drain on it. Awesome, awesome. Up the front, we've got this kickdown. Now, here, this is good. This is what I like. So we've got our gauges, we've got a 9-inch Lawrence sounder there, we've got the VHF radio, and because your feet come down, see how my legs are square there? That just works, it makes it ergonomic, it makes it easy. You got a couple of racks there, you can chuck some Eskies or life jackets in there, glove box there, you know, we've got books because this is a sold boat. I would put a mobile phone up there, a couple of drink holders, and of course this down here where you can stand through the walk-through windscreen up to the anchor, so you can lean forward and pull that anchor in, move it over, rotary molded. I tell you, really doesn't get any better than that. And if your boat hasn't got that, well, it's just not a Quinny. You've got that good rail to hold on to. The Bimini comes down on it. We won't even put the Bimini up today. 703 control box. You're looking at your sounder. Let's go and see how this baby goes, Dan. I like it, a lot of room. We'll go out and catch the tuna and we'll catch some snapper. So here we are, out in Moreton Bay, out from the Caboolture River, half an hour from Brisbane. We're in 3 metres of water, and we're in Quintrex's new 5 metre Fishabout. 90 horsepower Yamaha, awesome big boat. You know, have a look at the size of the fish, the cockpit in it. Awesome in terms of families, in terms of those people that want to go out, and you might have wanted to have a side console, you're worried about that, you put the beamy up, you water ski in one day, you put the whole family of five in it, huge amount of deck room, couple of eskies, you're fishing it, skiing it, have all of that fun. Now, I don't know if you can see, but we're in a bit over 3 metres and I can see the bottom. I can see crabs moving around, you know? Now, Dan, just for all you Victorians, because this is dedicated to all you poor Victorians in the cupboard. Now, have a look around. Half an hour from Brisbane, this is what it looks like. You got the hinterland, we're in the bay, you got Redcliffe over there, you got Moreton Island, Stratty's down here, Bribey Island's off to our left, that's actually Bribey Island, that what you see in here. If you're in Victoria, and you can see some bloke over there with a great big boat, he probably sold a unit in Sydney and ended up buying half of Queensland. Do yourself a favour, get out of that joint and get up here. Let's take off. All right, so I'll give it a squirt. Straight on the plane. Seconds on the plane. You know, what am I doing? I'm doing 4.9 and I'm doing 43 kilometres an hour and it's pretty easy. Then I'll just trim out a little bit. I've trimmed him out of about 4 or 5 bars. I've taken it to 5,000 revs and we're doing 49 Ks. Like a lot of these things, I just find you do a kilometre per K. Now I've wound it up, I'm at 6.1, which is nice, and I'm doing 61 kilometres an hour. So Moreton is about 25 K. I'm across there, half an hour. I'll push some gauges, I'll find out what my flow is. And I'm using 17. 18 now. 18 litres an hour. So, with a 90, I'm across to Moreton in half an hour. I've used $9 worth of fuel, 9 litres. Have a look at this. See if that drone can pick it up. See, and this is why these fishabouts, runabouts are so practical. Dan and I are at the front, you get some clears, you got the beamy. I've decided not to do the beamy. Well, I put it in a turn without telling Dan, you know, and it just held in there. I got to hold on because of G-forces. And I told you, I hurt me back. I went marlin fishing. They said, oh, why don't you fish 24 stand-up, Aaron? Well, I hooked something massive. I fought it for about an hour. And then I never got to see it. Line snapped, nearly broke me back. Couldn't walk for weeks. You gotta watch that. You watch some, you go out fishing with some rich bloke, you might come back in an ambulance. Now, look at this thing going. Just beautiful. Has that drone got us, Dan? All right, so I'll come back, and like we're jogging, let's see how it looks. So I'll stand up. So if the weather got rough, I could stand up here, drive, or I'm looking for birds and schools. What are we going? We're going 50. We're doing 53 revs, and I'm doing 50 kilometres. How's that work? 53 and 48. I better check on my GPS just to see if that... Yeah, it is. Bang on. That's good. So just on that tube on the Yamaha gauges, it's 100% accurate. With my GPS on the phone. Standing up, I've got plenty of room, I feel safe. I feel stable, actually. And it's quite comfortable. I would drive with one hand on the reel, one hand on here. bouncing with your legs. And look at that hull just spitting it out. And look how much working area. You know, for you Victorians, whether you're up at Eildon, Donnybrook, Bonnie Doon, you know, chasing trout, whether you're out at Marimbula, you know, out there chasing the tuna, this boat's got some deck space. You know, there's lots of, one of the bays, maybe you're in Port Phillip Bay, catching those King George whiting. That's one thing you Victorians have got on us Queenslanders. King George whiting. I reckon they're an awesome fish. I love them. I like eating them. I like catching them. There's nothing I don't like about them, to tell the truth, other than they're not here. When I first come to Queensland years ago, a year and a half before I kept a whiting, I thought they were all undersized. It wasn't. It's just the winter whiting and summer whiting are shies and ours. They're pretty tasty. I'm into them now, but not compared to a King George whiting. And have a look. See, I'm struggling with this boat to tell you anything it can't do. And because I don't have rough enough weather, but it holds in, it squirts it out back. See where that wave's coming? That means everyone's dry. I'll just do a little bit of circles, because everyone likes when I do circle work. See if we can get Dan's hair wet. Whoa, that's a... That's full turn. She's hanging in there, beautiful, isn't it? You know? Look at that. Now we'll go into a V8. Back over, into another turn. We're making patterns now. Look at this. Lucky number 8. Tell you what, talk about lucky numbers. We've been selling a lot of boats. We've been selling them all over. Haven't sold one to Victoria for a while. Got a lot of watchers down there, I know, because there's nothing else to do. It's so bloody cold. Watch football, eat meat pies, 420 meat pies. Look at this thing. You know, as a family boat, as a fishing boat, it's a 5 metre boat. No worries of going across to Morton, across there. No worries going on an exploratory trip, Wilson's Prom, or, you know, I don't know where you're going to go, Eden, down to Bateman's Bay, you know, take a big trip up to Queensland, tow it, stop at all the impoundments with the kids. You really couldn't do any better than this, could you? So whether you're out in an impoundment or out in the offshore, you know, if you're offshore bottom donging, absolutely wonderful. Feet are under, plenty of room. Look, your knees are up here, plenty of room in the back. Good boarding ladder over there that you could come in if you were diving even. Because this is a big boat, look at it. Look how much room, you know. Awesome, awesome title, all round boat. Fishing, skiing, boating, just having a wonderful time. Start that. Believe it or not, that motor's started. And what we'll do is we'll just motor off. Just like if you owned it, so you could see how it was. Give it a little bit of squirt. Gets on the plane instantaneously. Absolutely flawless. Plenty of power with that 90. I'm not saying, you know, you could probably get away with a 75. Maximum horse 90, same weight as a 75, so you might as well be the 90. And then we just scoot along. Once again, all of a sudden I ended up doing 50K, you know, which is a nice little speed. I put a little bit of trim on it. There's half trim, because what you've got is trim and tilt. Trim's the bottom bit and then tilt. This is the trim gauge, it's only the bottom part. And it's important because, oh, I'll do it. Watch how the water comes out the side of the boat. I haven't touched revs. As I come back down to no trim, the water's up here. As I trim out, the water comes back, right? And people go, what's all that about? Well, it's also about staying dry, because if that water's squirting out behind you, it'll never get you. And that's particularly with a tinny. Particularly with a tinny, and you've got the little bar that comes through, holds the motor. you can adjust it and change your tinny into a very, very dry boat, or if you have it all ballsed up, you get wet as a shag and just every wave comes over and hits you in the face. Have a look. We are lucky to be in Queensland. All you Queenslanders up here. You know, I've been up here nearly 30 years. And I love it. I love the outdoors. I like the environment. So it's a big boat. And it's got a lot of room and a lot of stability because of it. But, you know, it's not one that I can see to do anything dangerous in it. It just feels safe. I take grandma out, not a problem. Wife and kids, even newborns out in this thing. Store your stuff away, go across to Tangalooma, Victoria. Well, you'd rug up, get a doona on, a couple of puffer coats, you know, go and catch some snapper, whiting, flathead. Jesus, some good flathead. Look at that over here. There's some good flathead in Victoria. We like them. Good whiting, good flathead. Bloody cold though. Look at our sandbanks. Wonderful. And the boat's just going along. Then, what do I got? I've got a half trim. I'll give it a little bit more because I've got to test it. So I've gone up to $4,000-$6,000, which is full revs. $6,000, I'm doing 61 kilometres an hour. I would say if I was skiing, I might even change the prop because it had plenty out of the hole. But a lot of my mates cast big shadows, so I, if it was rough, you can't go that fast. You need a big boat to do 60 in, you know, when it's rough and it's blowing and you're out in the deep. And here we are in the mouth of the Caboolture River. Beautiful, just beautiful. Go over there and pump for nippers. You know, there's worm banks, little soldier crabs running around. It really is just a beautiful, beautiful state and a beautiful country and a beautiful place to be around, isn't it? You know, what a way to spend some time with your family. If you want to come out, you want to try a boat, we water test boats, we bring you out, I put you in a boat with one of the mechanics, you go and find out. You take your kids and your wives or your mates, bring Uncle Tom, you know, he knows all about boats. And bring him out and we'll put you on the water and show you what Quinnies do, what baseboard, what yellowfin do. Or one of our used boats are all tested. But I'll tell you what you do. Whatever you're going to do, if you're going to buy a boat, call the team at Brisbane Yamaha, 3888 1727, because I'm bloody starving. My wife just had it made me a couple of pickle, ham and pickle sandwiches, and I ate them on the way to work. And so now it's lunchtime, I'm off to get another couple, and I'll see you on the water.